यस सर। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वर्दी जजेस एंड ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम हियर टू प्रेजेंट प्रच माथुर भाषण प्रतियोगिता फॉर द टॉपिक हाउ टीचर बिकेम अ नर्चरर ऑफ इंडियन कल्चर। सो आई स्टार्ट विद इट। डियर फ्रेंड श्वेता, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन देयर, आई एम आल्सो गुड हियर। केम टू नो अबाउट योर परमानेंट सेटलिंग बैक इन भारत एंड योर वरीज अबाउट योर सन स्टडीज एंड एजुकेशन सिस्टम हियर। Dear Shweta, as a mother, it is a genuine concern, but may I, being a teacher of Indian education system, solace you by this letter that how a teacher has always been nurturer of our Indian society. A teacher, an educator, or a guide is a person who helps their students to acquire knowledge, competence, or virtue. Informally, the role of a teacher can be taken on by anyone, the one who imparts new knowledge and also inculcates curiosity to fetch new skills and to learn something. But our focus is on those who are employed as their main role to teach our child and nurtures him in a formal education context. An education system may vary among nations, but the teacher's role only varies as per child's needs. Is it here or there? But if I talk about Indian culture, since ancient times, the education was given with the objective of developing the students, not only in the outer body, but also on their inner body. The education focused on imparting ethics like humility, truthfulness, discipline, self-reliance, and respecting all creations to the students. The education was mostly imparted in ashrams, gurukuls, temples at that time. To keep the students' mind fresh and alive, education was given by gurus in peaceful forests under a blue sky. The students used to go to the hometown of teachers called gurukul, where they learn until the completion of their study. Ashrams and their feet were other learning centers where students used to come and learn from saints and sages. The educator always designed the syllabus in accordance with the demands of that specific era, like at the time of royal families or dynasties, or for the budding kings of states. Education system focused on subjects like warfare, military, politics, or religion. A teacher's objective is and was always remain to make the student future ready and survive in any situation. India had witnessed many idealistic teacher-student pairs in its long glorious history, like Dronacharya and Arjuna, Chanakya and Chandragupta, Sandipan and Krishna, and the modern times, Advaniji and Narendra Modi ji are some of the teacher-student duos that set a class of their own. Guru was and always worshipped in our culture by the mantra Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Deva Maheshwara, Gurur Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah. It was the medieval education when the ancient education was drastically changed. Now, the students did not live with their teachers like that time, but students were taught from the basics and practical education was given by educators, and the teacher adapted the changes and fostered their students as per the demand and need of the culture and society of that time. The modern education was introduced during the British Empire. Pupils were taught as per the ever-increasing demands, and relation with the teacher remains the same. The relation remains the same bond of respect and devotion, the relation which is supportive and productive for the child to feel emotionally and physically safe, whether it was a gurukul or ashram or in the modern day schools. Dear Shweta, in Bharat, teacher is called as the second mother of the child, and being a teacher, I make sure that in my classroom, I put relationship first. I want my students to know more from the very first day that they will be loved and supported all the year long. Even though rules are incredibly important, there should be specific rules to maintain the decorum of any classroom. But whatever you do, do with a smile. Smile big on the first day of the school and continue smiling each day. As time passes, more and more modernization is knocking the doors of teaching, but the basic ethnicity still exists to its very roots till today in our nation. Till today in our nation, the ceremony of Vidya Aram, which is one of the 16 samskars of our rituals and tradition, is performed. Vidya means knowledge and Arambham means beginning. Initiation into the world of syllabary usually begins with the writing of the mantra. Om Hari Shri Ganpati Namah, Vikanamastu, Shri Guruve Namah, Shri Saraswati Sahayam. Ceremony is conducted under the supervision of a master, where the child of age between 2 to 5 years write mantra on sand or on tray of grains, and the teacher writes the mantra on the child's tongue with gold. Writing on sand denotes practice. Writing on grains denotes acquisition of knowledge, which leads to prosperity. Writing on the tongue with gold invokes the grace of goddess of learning. The pandemic time was the most challenging period for all the educators worldwide, but this long shutdown inspired creative ways to teach thousands of students who could not even log on to online classes in several villages and remote areas across the country. Initiatives like Shiksha Aapke Dwar created more than 100 blackboards on the walls of the student houses in a village in Jharkhand. Did not have access to smartphones. Indramukhi Chetri, a teacher in Sikkim, visited homes of several students with count of 40 students in a week. Like this, a teacher in a village of Gujarat, Ghanshyam Bhai, used the public announcement system of the village to serve education. Another teacher in Chhattisgarh, Rudra Rana, conducted classes by reaching to rural areas on his motorcycle with portable umbrella and a chalkboard. Loudspeaker system on cars and vans were established, and turn-wise teachers were arranged to impart lessons from carts and vans, which were parked at visible location. Dear Shweta, all these arrangements and all this pain and efforts by teachers, mentors, guides, or educators were made just for the society, for our nation's future. Those are our young children. It is us who are going to decide the well-being of our nation. If I talk about our nation's national education policy, the education to be imparted by the teacher is completely child-centric for holistic development of the student. Through ECCE framework in Anganwadis, Nipun Bharat Abhiyan, Bal Vatikas, and other government-aided facilities and schemes, not only academics, but for the well-being of a child's health and nutrition and life skill development has been focused. Dear Shweta, the words are less to express the gratitude towards the teacher in Indian society. Not to give up to all this, but want to remind you that the CEOs of the big international companies across the globe are from Indian background and have been taught by our Indian teachers. We know it is parents who show us the light of this beautiful world, but teachers are the torch givers who explain the meaning and significance of these lights. If parents give food to eat, then teachers elucidate the importance and need for that food. If parents arrange luxuries to provide better comfort, then a teacher explicates the extent to which it is needed, along with saving it for future. In crux, a teacher is indeed constructive and momentous to lay the pillars of the student's lives in a correct posture, and not just shaping one student,
but is curving innumerable people through that one discipline. This could actually explain the power and dedication of the teacher who has the strength to contour, to build, and to strengthen the roots of our society. Yours loving, Manisha Singhal. Thanks.